Hi friends, welcome back to Curious With. I am Dr. Mohsina. In today's video, we will see one viral disease in small ruminants, that is caprine arthritis and encephalitis, CAE. So let's begin. Caprine arthritis and encephalitis virus infection is manifested clinically as polysynovitis arthritis in adult goats and less commonly as progressive paresis, leukoencephalomyelitis in kids. So it is having two different presentations in adult goats and kids as arthritis and polysynovitis in adult goats and progressive paresis in kids. Subclinical or clinical interstitial pneumonia, induritive mastitis or hard ardor and chronic wasting have also been contributed to infection with this virus. So you can see the pictures of interstitial pneumonia, induritive mastitis and chronic wasting caused by this virus. Most CAE virus infections, however, are subclinical. An infection with the CAE virus decreases the lifetime productivity of dairy goats and is a barrier to exportation of goats from North America. CAE virus infection is widespread among dairy goats in most industrialized countries, but rare among indigenous goat breeds of developing countries unless they have been in contact with imported goats. In countries such as Canada, Norway, France and USA, seroprevalence of CAE virus is more than 65%. Coming to the etiology. The CAE virus is an enveloped single-stranded RNA lentivirus in the family Retroviridae. There are several genetically distinct isolates of the virus that differ in virulence. The CAE virus of goats is closely related to the ovine lentiviruses causing ovine progressive pneumonia and Medivisna in North America and Europe respectively. Cross-species transmission is possible through feeding of infected milk and colostrum. Therefore, the ovine and caprine lentiviruses are now commonly referred to as small ruminant lentiviruses. Now let's see the epidemiology of CAE virus. CAE virus infection is widespread in dairy goat breeds but uncommon in meat and fiber producing goats. This have been attributed to the genetics, management practices such as feeding colostrum and milk from a single dam to multiple kids and industrialized farming practices, example frequent introduction of new animals into a herd. Prevalence of infection increases with age but is not influenced by sex. Most goats are infected at an early age, remain virus positive for life and develop disease months to years later. The chief mode of spread of CAE is through ingestion of virus-infected goat colostrum or milk by kids. The feeding of pooled colostrum or milk to kids is particularly risky practice because a few infected does will spread the virus to a large number of kids. Horizontal transmission also contributes to disease spread within herds and may occur through direct contact, exposure to fomites at feeding bunks and waterers, ingestion of contaminated milk in milking parlors, or serial use of needles or equipment contaminated with blood. Unlikely methods of transmission as indicated by experimental studies include in utero transmission to the fetus, infection of the kid during parturition, and infection through breeding or embryo transfer. Here also you can see chronic wasting caused by this virus in adult goats mainly. Now coming to the pathogenesis. Pathogenesis of CA is not fully understood. Virus infected macrophages in colostrum and milk are absorbed intact through the gut mucosa. An infection is subsequently spread throughout the body via infected mononuclear cells. Periodic viral replication and macrophage maturation induces the characteristic lymphoproliferative lesions in target tissues such as lungs, synovium, choroid plexus, and udder. Persistence of CA virus in the host is facilitated by its ability to become sequestered as provirus in host cells, and infection induces a strong humoral and cell-mediated immune response, but neither is protective. Now let's move on to the most important part, that is the clinical findings. Clinical signs are seen in approximately 20% of CA virus infected gods during their lifetime. The most common manifestations of infection is polysynovitis arthritis, which is primarily seen in adult gods, but can occur in kids as young as 6 months old. Can see the picture of arthritis here. Signs of polysynovitis arthritis include joint capsule distension and varying degree of lameness. The carpal joints are the most frequently involved. The onset of arthritis may be sudden or insidious, but the clinical course is always progressive and affected gods lose condition and usually have poor haircuts. Encephalomyelitis is generally seen in kids 2 to 4 months old, but has been described in older kids and adult gods. Affected kids initially exhibit weakness, ataxia, and hind limb placing deficits. Hypertonia and hyperreflexia are also common. Over time, signs progress to paraparesis or tetraparesis and paralysis. Depression, head tilt, circling, opisthotonus, torticollis, and paddling have also been described. The interstitial pneumonia component of CA virus infection rarely produces clinical signs in kids. However, in adult gods with serologic evidence of CA virus infection, chronic interstitial pneumonia that leads to progressive dyspnea has been documented. The hard udder syndrome attributed to CA virus infection is characterized by a firm, swollen mammary gland and agalaxia at the time of parturition. Milk quality is usually unaffected. Although the mammary gland may soften and produce close to normal amounts of milk, production remains low in many gods with indurative mastitis. Coming to the lesions, pathologic lesions of CA virus infection are generally described as lymphoproliferative with degenerative mononuclear cell infiltration. Lesions in joints are characterized by thickening of joint capsule and marked proliferation of synovial villi. In chronic cases, soft tissue calcification involving joint capsules, tendon sheath, and bursae is not uncommon. Severe cartilage destruction, rupture of ligaments and tendons, and periarticular osteophyte formation have also been described in advanced cases. Microscopic features of articular lesions include synovial cell hyperplasia, subsynovial mononuclear cell infiltration, villus hypertrophy, synovial edema, and synovial necrosis. Gross lesions associated with the neurologic form of CAE include asymmetric brownish-pink swollen areas, most commonly in the cervical and lumbosacral spinal cord segments. Histopathologically, these lesions are characterized by multifocal mononuclear cell, inflammatory infiltrates, and varying degrees of demyelination. On gross examination, lungs of affected gods are firm and grey pink with multiple small white foci and do not collapse. The bronchial lymph nodes are invariably enlarged, and histopathologic findings include chronic interstitial pneumonia with mononuclear cell infiltration in alveolar septi and in perivascular and peribronchial regions. In dose with adder induration, mononuclear infiltration of periductular stroma obliterates the normal mammary tissue. You can see the picture of an indurated adder in an adult's got caused by CA virus here. Coming to the diagnosis, a presumptive diagnosis can be based on clinical signs and history. Infectious arthritis caused by mycoplasma species and traumatic arthritis are differential diagnoses for arthritis induced by CA virus. Differential diagnosis for the progressive paresis and paralysis exhibited by young kids should include enzootic ataxia, spinal cord abscess, cerebrospinal nematodiasis, spinal cord trauma, and congenital anomalies of spinal cord and vertebral column. If the neurologic examination indicates brain involvement, polyencephalomalacia, listeriosis, and rabies should be considered as possible causes. The pulmonary form of caseous lymphadenitis may have a similar clinical presentation to the pulmonary form of CA in adult gout. So all the diseases mentioned here will come under the differential diagnosis of CA. Both an AGAGEL immunodiffusion test and ELISA for CA virus are considered sufficiently reliable for use in control programs. The AGAGEL immunodiffusion test is reported to be more specific but less sensitive than ELISA. A positive test result in an adult cord implies infection but does not confirm that the clinical signs are caused by CA virus. Kids infected at birth develop a measurable antibody response. However, positive test results in kids less than 90 days old usually reflect cholesterol antibody transfer. Negative test results do not reliably exclude CA virus infection because the time for post-infection seroconversion is variable and occasional gouts have a very low titer that may not be detectable. And low antibody titers are common in late pregnancy. Because of the limitations of serological testing, the definitive diagnosis of clinical CA requires demonstration of characteristic lesions in biopsy specimens or at necropsy, and virus isolation or PCR to demonstrate presence of viral antigen in tissues may be used to further substantiate the diagnosis. Coming to the treatment and control, there is no specific treatment for any of the clinical syndrome associated with CA virus infection. However, supportive treatment may benefit individual gouts. The condition of gouts with polysynovitis arthritis may be improved with regular foot trimming, use of additional bedding, and administration of NSAIDs such as phenylbutazone or aspirin. Gouts with encephalomyelitis can be maintained for weeks with good nursing care, and antimicrobial therapy is indicated to treat secondary bacterial infections that may complicate the interstitial pneumonia or interactive mastitis components of CA virus infection. Providing high quality, readily digestible feed to gouts positive for CA virus may delay the onset of wasting syndrome. In commercial heads, one or more of the following have been recommended for control of CA. One is permanent isolation of kids beginning at birth, feeding of heat-treated colostrum and pasteurized milk, frequent serologic testing of the head with identification and segregation of seronegative and seropositive gouts, and eventual culling of seropositive gouts. If the control program includes segregation of herds into seropositive and seronegative groups, the groups should be separated by a minimum of 6 feet, that is 1.8 meter, and shared equipment should be disinfected using phenolic or quaternary ammonium compounds. So that's all about that's all about caprine arthritis and encephalitis or CA virus infection, small ruminants. If the video is informative and useful, please like the video and share it with your friends. And if you are new to this channel and not subscribed yet, please subscribe and click the notification bell so that you get notified each time I upload a video. So see you soon with another video. Thank you.